In the video before, we have installed the AMS software on the system. In the video hereafter, we will start with the actual configuration. In this video, however, we first perform the parts that we need before we can actually add the devices. We will first check the rights for the computer and the user, and then create an area that represents the map. We will start the AMS config tool with administrative credentials. Without these credentials, you have no access to the administrator account in AMS, and you also cannot modify the licenses. For the time being, the administrator is the only account. When the administrator logs on for the first time, the password is also administrator. However, after first log on, we must change that password. The password change was done in the previous video where we installed the AMS and started the config tool for the first time. We will start creating a new account for the operator. That should happen in two steps. The first step is in the personal data. Here we always go to when we need to create a new person. That person could either be a login name that we want to access the software, or that person could be a card holder that needs just access to an area. The required fields for a person are last name and person class. Person class in this case is employee. The second step takes place in the user rights. You find user rights under configuration and then operators and workstations. Here we set the username. The username can differ from the user's real name. The username is the name that is used to log on together with the password. A password is required. To provide rights to the user, we will assign a profile. The profile UP administrator is a pre-configured profile. That profile is also assigned to the administrator account. Profiles can be checked and created under user or workstation profiles. In this case, we assigned a user profile. The user profile UP administrator appears to be the only pre-configured user profile. It contains all the user rights that exist. If you need different rights for a specific user, you can create your own profile. Also, the computer that runs the AMS software needs sufficient rights. Let's check that. Now we go to workstation rights and we see that there is already a workstation configured. This is the computer where the software is initially installed. We can verify that by comparing the computer's host name with the workstation name in AMS. If you need to run the AMS config tool on another computer, add that computer also to the list of workstations. The workstation also contains an assigned profile. That is the WP administrator profile. Also, that profile contains all the rights needed. If there is a conflict between the user rights and the workstation rights, then the workstation right will take precedence. We will now focus on the map view. Typically, the application that the operator watches to see the events and alarms coming in. Let's see if we can start the map view with the new created operator account. You can choose if you already want to see the alarms in the map view. In this phase, the alarms are not too important. Let's skip them for now and delete them forever. To add a new map, we first need to switch to the edit mode. From there, we can add a new image by clicking the plus icon. Find a map that represents the floor plan of the building that you want to protect. That image might be a JPG, a BMP or a PNG drawing. In this example, we see an office building with a couple of small office rooms. The door that we want to protect is the left main door. The main door is the entrance between the outside and the office building. So we need two areas, outside and inside. It is in the device data tool where we will create the areas. outside already exists. We only have to create the inside. We will name that the office building. That will become the destination in the next video where we will create the entrances. This is where the preparation ends. In the next video, we will configure the controller with an entrance, a door and two readers.